Good morning, everybody. It is nice to have you all in the webinar with a weekend where we call Right Talk with the Right Horizons, with the awareness, taking care, how you can take care of your personal finance and achieve your financial goal. So we are talking about here Right Horizons FinTalk, where we are trying to take you what is the right insurance. And this, I think so the importance came very, very critical. Only last 1 or 2 years we have seen. And this is really paying a, I think so, good kind of thought process in our near and dear ones and ourselves. So I thought I will share a few examples of people whom I have been handling, the way we can learn from others, not to have a reinvent the wheel ourselves every time. We don't have a time, so it's already very short and sweet, our life. So better learn how we can try to do. So today I'm just trying to say, what is exactly the risk? Why somebody need an insurance? Actually, you may not need an insurance, but to understand the insurance, we need to know what is a risk and what are the different types of insurance we have. And today we will focus on health side and how we will be able to identify what is right insurance I should take it across. And insurance is always a highest part or a first thing to look at when we are talking about a financial freedom. So for a freedom, it can be anything for everybody. It is like a, you are free from financial debt. You are free from taking care of any decision. You are taking care. So most of the time, 90% of the time, we will feel very comfortable when we have a financial backup. I'll give you a simple example. If somebody came and told me, Rachna, I am facing some medical issue. Please let me know. Is it I have enough money if I quit and I don't earn? So I can get a monthly income this much. So I calculated and I said, yes, you can. So because a person has a financial backup, he was able to take a decision which is going to impact his future income. So sometimes freedom makes a lot of difference in different people, but there is no doubt about it. Health is always a wealth. There is no second thought. And today that's what we are trying to focus on. So health and the life is the one thing which is most risk management we have to take. So in a financial planning, we are first way is to make sure that we are managing a risk. And after managing a risk, we go for investment and then you go for appreciation and maybe from the wants, like you having a good vacation and other things. So the basic thing is always how to make sure that we are able to manage the risk. Risk is a very, very important. So everybody have a different perceiving notion what is a risk. Even though this is not related to this, but I can tell you one person, he called me and he says that, Rachna, I'm ready to take a risk if you give me very high return. And I told him, it always is not proportionate. So you can't say that I'm taking a risk and you give me the high return. Sometimes when you're taking a risk, you may not get the principal also. So we should also know how much risk I can take. So this is the example, one of our board member itself, long back used to say that, Rachna, I have enough emergency money and all this stuff. So why I need a health insurance? Then I was asking, how much you think we should normally keep emergency money? The emergency money we normally keep around 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs or plus. Then I said, if somebody is not well, the 10 lakhs and 20 lakhs, you have used it. But after 1 year, 2 years, again, you have to build the same emergency fund. So health insurance is making sure that every year on year, you are getting as a buffer of, like you can think so-called of emergency fund only for a health. Okay. So I'll just take a superset today. What is a risk management, then investment and overall, because our intention is to make sure you achieve your financial goals. And today's focus is to make sure that we have risk management very well.
For building a house, it is essential to create a perfect blueprint for the same. Similarly, for building a wealth for you and your family, requires you to build a financial blueprint, also known as financial plan. Here are the 5 steps of building successful financial plan. Planning for uncertainty. First step is to protect yourself from uncertainty by buying required insurance policies to ensure that any uncertainty do not eat up your savings. Build contingency corpus. Second step is to build contingency corpus up to 6 to 9 months of your monthly expenses. This will protect your long-term investments from the contingencies like loss of job or slowdown in business. Set financial goals. Third step is to set financial goals and find out when and how much money would you require to achieve these financial goals. Create portfolio. Fourth step is to select right asset class and product to invest and to achieve your financial goals based on the time horizon and your risk appetite. Portfolio review. Fifth step is to review your portfolio periodically and do the necessary adjustments into it based on the remaining time period to achieve each goal. To create a financial plan and to review it periodically.
So today we are talking about the first and second steps, what they were talking about, how to take care of a contingency and how to take care of a risk management, and especially on a health side. So what are the things which make sure that how much risk we can have and how much we can pass it on to others? So if you ask, in India is a one company where we say that we are underinsured and oversaved. So what happened? We always think that this risk may not come to me. I'm fit and fine. I'm doing the health. I'm eating well. I'm doing very good fitness. So sometimes I am sure if you go back and think yourself in last 1-2 years, and I used to ask this question to Vanil and everybody, he was so fit and fine. He is so young. He is so good. He was so health conscious. How come suddenly this happened? It may be through COVID or what may be the reason. But we realize it, the risk can come anywhere and anytime. It doesn't knock and come. So one is, of course, the health side, how we have to take care. But at least, are we prepared in case of risk coming that we will be able to get the best of facilities, the best of treatment? How to make sure that is the one part what we are trying to speak. How we can make sure that we get a good health cover, what are the aspects of health cover, and how we can make sure that we have a very, clear mind. So I'll give you my own example. This is what happened around, I think, so we have paid 6 years back. One of our customer came and he asked us, can I get a 1 crore of health cover? And I said, there was no available of 1 crore health cover at all. And then I asked, why you need 1 crore? I have never given anybody more than 25 lakhs. And then this is because, God grace, you have not gone through the critical illness in your family or something. If that is a reason, sometimes the money goes much beyond. So he says that, why don't you think, because we used to have a 10 lakhs that time. And he said, why don't you think having a much more? And then being ourselves as a broker, I asked my team to give it some. Quotation of 25 lakhs and 50 lakhs. And to my surprise, I still remember that the premium of 25 lakhs and 50 lakhs was only 3,500 difference. And I said, there's not even any rocket science that I have to go into 50 lakhs because it is so cheap. So what I have noticed is the health cover, of course, last 1.5 years, the health cover has gone very high because of mortality charges are high. People have died quite high and because of COVID. But that time, because we have taken a 6 years back, the 50 lakhs cover was much, much cheap. And you won't believe when people has to say that, okay, we should take a COVID cover separate or not separate, Rashna, what to do and all this stuff. And I was saying, anyway, we have a 50 lakhs cover for all the family. So everything will be considered because COVID was a part of the overall cover also. So the peace of mind it gives you because you are taken care of for unknown risk. I can tell you it is much beyond that few thousands of a premium it is. So what is a risk? Risk is normally what a condition which is a possibility may come. It's not sure that it may 100% come. It may be a 1%, maybe 0.1%. It's the same thing I can say always, like a car. I've been driving more than I think so. When I got it 98, almost like a 23 years I've been driving. I have never even dashed somebody. But you have been paying the car insurance, correct? It may be a 0.001% of the things that people may use the car insurance money. But the question is, some people else must be using. It's a probability cases. So risk is, in case it comes, somebody will take care of me. So that is the one thing. Of course, car insurance is more of a third party insurance that you have to make sure that you are not hurting third person. But most of us, we have to see, can I take care of a risk myself or not? And is it is going to impact my financial loss or not? So the possibility of loss, it can be anything, mainly on finance side, we try to take care by the insurance. Of course, there is a lot of type of risk I am trying to take today is more on a pure risk, which is a health, which is personal risk, risk of death, pure health, living so long, if you're living 100 plus years, how you're going to manage. So I'm looking for a pure risk today, which is a health side. So whenever there is a risk comes, there are different types of things we can say that we can try. Okay, I'm trying to avoid it. So I may avoid, I can say, not eating a healthy food. So I will eat only healthy food. I may try to be having a good disciplined life. I cannot 100% ignore, but I can avoid it. Okay. In the health side, I'm trying to say, you are controlling the things. Like today only I'm going to meet one of my customer and he says, no, Rachna, Bangalore has been so overcrowded and now working from home. I'm shifting to the place, that's Coimbatore, where it is much more better and the air is fresh and the area is so good. You can control in some point of a time. It can be, but it cannot be all. So you can control in a health side is how the oxygen level, they say it's a very pure, that's what he believes in. Maybe true also, I'm not sure. But I'm saying cities are getting a lot of crowded and there's oxygen level. Like somebody told me in a person who was coming from Delhi and he says, if you go one day fully in Delhi, it is looks like that you have 7 cigarettes you have already gone inside you. That's the equivalent of carbon you have it in your lungs. I said, oh my God, I never knew about it. So there is a control some point how much you can do it. Then you can say, okay, basic, if there is a health issue, I may have a emergency 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs, 5 lakhs or 10 lakhs. I can accept that much of financial because I'm keeping a backup. But if you think that I am not able to do because it goes beyond that, you will try to transfer it. And transferring of your risk to the third party is called an insurance, because they take care of probability basis, and that's where we are going to handle today. So I'll have a small video on what is a health insurance and why we need.
They say health is wealth. Unfortunately, it is true when you fall ill. A study revealed that medical inflation in India is likely to rise at 10%. So by 10 years, the cost of heart surgery would be 2.5 times more than today. Studies conducted in 2016 reveals that approximately 20 lakh people suffer from heart attack every year. 25% of death occurs in the age group of 25 to 29 years. One person is killed due to heart attack every 33 seconds. And about 4 crore Indians suffer from heart disease in India. If you don't have a sufficient amount to pay medical bills in your savings account, which is a better option? Break your long-term investments or sell your home or gold. Borrow money from relatives or friends. Buy a health insurance policy. Your decision to buy sufficient health insurance cover will protect your loved ones today and tomorrow. To buy the best policy suitable to your needs, act.
So that is what I was trying to say. It's always better to transfer your risk to somebody who can take care of a bigger amount of your health side. And second thing is, it will always make you, I can say, power of decision works very well. You have a freedom in your mind, you have a better sleep, and you think it is giving you a better way of looking outwards, because you can tell other people how they are feeling. So what is an insurance type? Most of the time, you all must have heard it's a life insurance or non-life, which is called GI, general insurance. General insurance is anything other than the life is called under general insurance. So motor, fire, marine, you can say assets, any assets. So health is one of them, which is very, very prominent. So I will talk about today health. So health insurance is the one most of the time when we go and ask, is it you have an health insurance or not? So my answer I get it across is only two levels. One is, I'm too young, I may not need the health insurance. Second is, I have it whatever a corporate has given to me. I may not have anything other than that. Most of the corporate, whoever I know of, people are having a 5 to 7 lakhs. Very few people have 10 to 15 lakhs. And being the last 1 year, we have seen if somebody has gone to the good hospital and COVID, even though there was not maximum, I can say, treatment for COVID, but staying in ICU, utilizing all those things, it is coming approximately 7 to 10 lakhs plus. Because we have seen one of our own known person, it went to 17 lakhs also. So most of the time, we all don't give that much importance to our health. Even though we know health is wealth. Wealth will come later. First, we should make sure our health is there. So how we can make sure that we give that much importance to ourselves and we spend some money on our health and making our near and dear one and family members much, much more comfortable, that in case of emergency comes, we are in a good phase that we can handle ourselves. You will be surprised to know nowadays, a lot of time, our longevity has gone much beyond 85. But our healths are not going high. So we have a walking group, and in walking group, two of them, they keep saying that that uncle and that person, he himself is 76, if I'm not wrong. And he's telling my mother is 96 and she is perfectly fine and she stays independently. She cooks herself and everything. And I was telling, this is amazing because she's doing all the work. That's why she's able to sustain even 96. So nowadays, the people living long is also there. But I am not sure our age, because there are so many contaminants late. We have a not so good habit of eating. We keep going out. We eat so many junk foods. Our kids are being addicted from the young that they want pizza, pasta, burger, aerated drinks, thumbs up, Coke, whatever it is. But I'm trying to say, we don't have such a good, and very few of us have the habit of every day taking care of our health by any sports or walking or jogging or something. How to develop that? It's a both part of it, and make sure that in case something happens, we have enough money to take care of. So always prepare for an emergency and protect your all the family and yourself, that in case of emergency comes, you are ready. How much is enough? That is another question. And I spend today a lot of time in your queries and questions, because these questions keep coming, especially on the family floaters. And when the kids are becoming big, how we should take care of family floaters, employee versus employer, what you call health cover. So to me, enough, according to me, is 10 to 15 is still okay. But if you are able to get a 20 plus is the best I will think of. These are the survey done by post-COVID health insurance trends. What is happening? So if you see the millennial is the young people now realize the need of comprehensive health covers. Previously, it was 37% and now it is 60%. And not only that, nowadays a lot of people have started thinking, okay, we should go for a regular health cover checkup. Previously, people was not doing that much. And this is the same thing, critical illness. Critical illness is the set of disease which comes under a part of it. Like you can say cancer or the heart or any other things like that. We always used to say that previously it was not enough. Now it is gone very high to take a top up and a critical illness when they are buying the health insurance. So this is the another factor people used to say, coverage amount on the top criteria, why people, what are the things which will make the decisions to buy the things. So some things which comes the highest is what is the coverage amount. Of course, what is we call a sum assured, what is the total, like a 3 lakhs, 5 lakhs. Those are the amount which people will look at. Cashless facilities are the second level people have looked at. So these are the two topmost people will ask, and you should also focus on how much I can utilize in a 1 year. And what is a utilize means how many hospital people can use those cashless facilities. So whenever you are looking for the health cover, there is a new thing has come. A lot of people must have utilized. It's called super top up. So if you noticed it last time, it was says that you can buy only COVID covers. And you must have got it from the current health insurance also, that if you want, you can take a super top up, which may have only a COVID or it will have a, another overall level also. So this is what is mean by top up.
Worried? Because your existing health insurance cover is less? Here is a solution. Buy Super Top Up Policy, which is a cheaper way to upgrade your health insurance cover. Say you have an existing cover of Rs. 3 lakhs and you want to increase it to Rs. 10 lakhs. Buy Super Top Up Policy of 7 lakh rupees with a deductible of Rs. 3 lakhs. The deductible is the amount of hospital bill which you need to pay from your base policy before the Super Top Up Policy is to be used. Now, if your claimable hospital bill is 4 lakh rupees, then your existing policy will pay 3 lakh rupees and the remaining 1 lakh rupees will be paid by Super Top Up Policy. If you fall ill again and run up a bill up to 6 lakh rupees again, don't worry, your Super Top Up Policy will take care of it. Super Top Up Policy is available for individuals also and as a family floater also. Call us now to buy the best Super Top Up Policy and to upgrade.
So what are the things you should look at when you are looking at the family health cover or any of the risk things? So we call as a risk profiler. And this, I always believe you may have it in your family, either a WhatsApp group or a someplace or a file, which may be a password protected and everybody is aware of. What we have done it, we have made one group and we have starred all those things, especially anything like a medical cover details, if you have a PAN or Aadhaar details. So anytime any of the family members require that, that may be utilized anytime. So I also believe it's better you should write it somewhere or give it to family member in case of emergencies. We must have these details handy, because when you are having this risk cover, we don't have in our mind which file to go and take it if it is not in a accessible mode, and we will be easily going with a car or the ambulance must have gone. So because at the time of admission, they will ask you what are the details for the health insurance. So most of the time we should have keeping ourselves, what is our term and the savings and the health, especially what is the coverage we have, how much sum assured we have, what is the, if it is from a company also, what is the, we call get a health card, the card details, and is it an individual or corporate, which company it is being linking towards. These details, please keep it in. In this, you may have a critical illness, you may have a top up, you have a personal accidental cover. And in case if it is for your parent and it is from their employer or from your side also, please let us
know if it is a copay, okay? Because for parents and some disease, they give it as a copay. Copay means is a simple thing. I can give you an example of copay is 10%. If they are saying it's a copay, they will write it in a policy called copay is equal to 10% or 20% copay. Some percentage number they will give you. That means that if bill came 1 lakh rupees and the copay is 20,000, 20%, so 20,000 rupees you will, or whoever has gone, that person will pay first and then the insurance triggers. Okay. So please be aware of copay. Very, very important. This is the one thing, because we do take care of a corporate insurance. Whenever we get a call from a lot of employees there, they have not seen the copay part of it and the insurance claim doesn't come. So these are the records. Please keep it. If you all have not done it, please today keep this part of it, because it's very good for future. As I told you, we don't know when the risk occurs. These are the few terms you must know. So one is the people get confused between premium and the sum assured. Premium is the money what you have to pay year on year. Okay. Please make sure, I have been doing to in my calendar and make it in a Google calendar, write a repeat every year, easiest way, because it will show you early morning in the mobile or wherever you write your calendar, I don't know. Because all these general insurance, whatever come under insurance, it's called a 1 year renewal. Even though you have paid for 10 years, I can tell you. And one of my customers, I was fighting the case and I didn't win that case also. She was paying that medical insurance very easily. And 1 year she missed it. So they gave her interest for one more month grace, and afterwards they didn't give it and it got elapsed. Elapsed means closed. And then she wanted to revoke it because she got some medical issue where she has to go for the admission. And this was the one of my better learning, I can say, because we tried high. We were not able to revive that policy because they have been more than 3 months over, not paid the premium. And taking a new policy, she was not able eligibility to take that operation. So she has to wait for 4 more years and which she cannot. So she has to pay the full amount from her money. So sometimes we always, and that forget it, anybody, my parents have done this. They were paying, he was in a army. So he always used a army hospital and all. So he was doing the previously with other third party. And suddenly what happened that he says, I'm not using for 10 years. What is the use? My premium is gone. My money is lost and all. And he didn't pay it. And you will surprise you that the next year itself, when we were there and Ami Hospital was not there and we were not able to take it and we have to pay everything. So please try to understand the premium is much, much smaller than what probability you may have it. And you are taking care of more. So even if you have a 10 lakhs, you may be paying approximately, I'm just thinking around 15 to 20,000 rupees, depending on your age. And they takes when you're taking a family floater, the age of the oldest family member. But still, it is better than taking care of 10 lakhs yourself. Okay. Beneficiary is always in a term cover. Who will be a person who gets the money, which is in a term cover, not in health. Sum assured is the thing what I already told you, that you're taking a 10 lakhs, 15 lakhs, how much maximum you can utilize if you are admitted for 1 year. So they call a policy calendar. It's not that financial year, or I can say the calendar from January to December. So in case if I am taking today policy, so from today to one more year is your policy calendar. And you need to pay after that. So you can claim full 10 lakhs from today to next 1 year, which is a sum assured. Claims. So maturity benefit doesn't come into this. So maturity benefit normally comes in the term. So where claims? Claims is when the incidence has happened. So means you have gone, got it admitted. Health insurance, very few people gives for not admitted. So normally they say is within 24 hours you should get admitted and then you can get the benefit of most of the time in a health cover. So you will try to claims. The claims are two types. As I was trying to tell you in advance also, that most of the time you will have either we normally say you will do reimbursements or you will be doing a cashless. So cashless is most of us, at least in Bangalore and others I have seen, is we will give the details of our policy that they, that whatever is a hospital or clinic you have gone, if they have tied up, they will send it to the RTA to the how much claim you can get it. And then rest we will take care of it. So most of us, we do a cashless. But if some places where you have gone to the hospital and that hospital is not linked to their network, you have to pay and then submit all the bills to the whichever hospital you have a health cover you have taken, and then they will give you the claim part of it. Family floater is always a beneficial because it takes care of, they say, 1+2, 1+1, 2+1, like that they keep taking across. So it's a one person, then your family, spouse and the kids. So most of the time, 1+1+3 is the maximum they can take it, but we can easily split also. Family floater is good because that amount is can be utilized by anyone. But the reverse is, you cannot go more than that. So if I have a family floater of 10 lakhs, for example, amongst all the four family members, I can claim maximum 10 lakhs only. I'm not able to claim 10 lakhs. It's not that. I'm going to claim 10 lakhs full family. That is why it's called family floater. What are the benefits? We can take it. So 10-10D and ATC is part of a term cover. So ATD is the one thing which is comes under the health cover, where you can claim up to 25,000 per year for your family and 50,000 for your dependent parents. Okay, so these two gets a tax benefit also. So this is what I have it more from the health cover perspective. So I wanted to give you a few FAQ on an employee and an employer. So most of the people, they do take care of health cover from their company. Whenever they you take from an employee, first thing you need to ask them, in case if I exit or quit the company, can I convert this existing health cover into my individual name or not? Okay. If you are not able to do so, please make sure that you have an alternative health cover, because in the last Feb 2020, we have faced this also. One of our customers is supposed to join another new company in April, but he says that, okay, I will take the break before joining new because I've been doing so much. His last day was in Feb end, and March was a place where he didn't have his own cover because he was very sure that he is joining back in a March, April 1st week. And as a, I can say, sometimes risk never comes, and he got the heart attack and he has to go for stent operation, and he paid around 10 to 12 lakhs his own. So sometimes it's better when employee and employer is not converting into the individual level of your policy. It is better to have always an alternative. Take a smaller level, maybe 3 to 5 lakhs. What will happen when you are not utilizing yours? Your things are no claim bonus and other thing keeps going on, and you always have an alternative, because when you exit from a corporate, you may be 45, 50 or 55. And that time, sometimes it may happen that because of age, we get some add-on disease, or we can say we can get a BP or sugar or something or others. And then getting a medical claim is very, very tough. It's always good to have term cover and health cover as early as possible. So this, with this, I'm just trying to open with a forum on the question and answers.
Yes, ma'am. So the first question is from SK. If hospitals are aware we have insurance, they usually charge a higher amount to the insurance. Why is this the case? This will reduce our cover eventually. And how do we handle this situation?
I am fully agree with you. I have not sure how I can think of, but if we are not able to do, then you have to make sure. Most of the people I have known that this is Rachna, I can manage the bills now and then I will claim it. So they will tell that we don't have an insurance and they pay the full hospital bills and then they do the claims. But most of the time we may not have such a high value with us. So they always try to do. Government is trying, you will be surprised to know that all health insurance companies are bleeding actually. Okay. Their P&Ls are not good because whatever we have paid the premium, the claims are much higher on overall level. So there is an approach letter has already gone to the IRDA that they are going to get segregation on four layers. Four layers means it will say that which policy you have and what kind of hospitals you can go for. And that will make sure that we will have a third party check. So this is going to have that if you're going to the hospital, I'm just giving example XYZ, I don't want to name it. And that is saying this overall, because they have in a package for this, it will take 3 to 5 lakhs. So independent team will come and assess, is it 3 to 5 lakhs as an average across or not? If not, they can take an action on the hospital also. Okay, this is not yet come as a policy by IRDA, but approach letter has already given to them. Yeah, second question.
Yes, ma'am. The second question is from Krishna. I have a sum assured of 10 lakh as medical policy individual for each family member. I'm exploring an additional super top of 20 lakhs. How useful is super top and what is suggested deductible? With 5 lakhs, the premium is high. The call center suggests to take 10 lakhs deductible.
Is it 5 lakhs deductible or 20 lakhs deductible?
1 minute,
I'll just
try to get it. 10 lakhs deductible, yes.
So you're trying to say you have current 10 lakhs medical policy of each. So indirectly you are having, if you are 4 members, you have 10 lakhs, 10 lakhs, 10 lakhs, 10 lakhs. Am I right, Krishna?
Yes, he said.
Yeah. So easiest way for everybody, if you don't have a bigger amount, super top up is the best thing because your premiums is 1/4 of that. Okay. So super top up, we should always take it, or critical illness, you can say it or whatever. Top up is good because it takes care of all disease and critical illness takes only for few disease. So you can take a top up anyway. Okay. But second question is how useful is super top up for what you have suggested as a deductible? Deductible is only from which kitty it is going the first. Okay. So if you are having, I'm just saying 10 lakhs and the bill came to 12 lakhs. So first they will take from your 10 lakhs as the first and then deductible goes to the super top up. So super top up is, I can say it's like a floating things. It is like a nowadays lot of health cover has come in a different, I can say, because all of them IRDA related. So they will have 2 or 3 differentiators. Okay. So I remembered even Religare have a carry forward also. So in case, if you are 10 lakhs policy and you got it into 12 lakhs, you can take the next year 2 lakhs now and next year you will have a maximum 8 years. So they, some of them are having a different small changes in their policies. So with a 5 lakhs of premium will be always higher. I will prefer to have a family floater than an individual always, because then you will be able to take in a higher with a less premiums. This is another question I forgot to tell you. Above 25, if your kids are there, family floater doesn't allow them. For them, you need to take an individual only. So if your kids are grown up, and you are getting a renewal, so it's better you can just ask them both the renewals. what is coming a cheaper individual one versus this. Otherwise, they can start taking, because when they are young, their health covers is much, much cheaper. So I always say by 24, 23, you can start seeing if you can split the family floater and the kid who is just crossing, going to cross 25.
Next question from Mayank. What is the difference between top up and super top up?
Top up and super top up.
I am also not sure of this. I thought both are the same.
But Rachna, it depends on Rachna.
Yeah, Rachna. Well, Lina will tell. Yeah, she is the best person. Yeah, yes, Lina.
Yeah, I can clarify that. Top up is if you have taken a you have a base policy for 5 lakhs, and you have taken a super top up. Top up policy for say 10 lakhs, and your deductible is 5 lakhs. Then top up policy will come into picture when your bill goes beyond 5 lakhs. So every claim to initiate, your base bill should be, the 5 lakh deductible should be there in the top up. Okay. Every claim should have a, it should trigger beyond 5 lakhs. It should be 5 lakh and 1 rupee, then only, or 5 lakh and 50 rupees, then only you can claim. If your base sum is insured is over and your next claim has come to 2 lakhs, then you cannot claim from top up policy. But in a super top up, the first time you have to, your claim has to go, the deductible has to be 5 lakh, and say, for example, in the next time, your bill has come 2 lakhs, then they will, you can initiate the super top-up. That means, in a simple way, top-up policy, each time the claim has to be beyond deductible amount. In a super top-up, first time, when you are claiming, your deductible has to happen, and the second claim during the year, it can be even a lesser amount. That is the difference between super top up and top up. Hope I'm clear. I made it clear. So is it?
Yeah, Rachna and Lina, I had one doubt.
Yes.
Can we directly take a super top up, or should we take a top up and only then a super top up?
No, you can. It is always better you go for a super top up, because some companies, for example, if you ask me, the New India Assurance, they don't have a super top up. They have a top up policy. Whereas there is some private insurance, they have a super top up policy. So it is always do some homework and get a super top up policy is always better.
So I can directly just go in for a super top up, right?
Yes,
so,
yes.
Yeah, okay.
Because when the claim comes, see, these are all the small differences. Only when the practically, when the claim comes, only we'll come to know. And having a, say, some more, most of the time, super top up policies are, you can take up to 25 lakhs, 50 lakhs. And having so much of sum insured, sometimes if you are not able to claim, it is a big pain. It is because you will come to know what is the underlying condition only when the real claim comes.
Thank you, Lina, and she's been amazingly doing well in a health and the other insurance. So she is better than mine. Of course, I have not sure, as she says, we have more on Apollo and all. So what I understood from her, to just give a brief, it's better if we can get a super top up than a top up, because otherwise the deductible every time it has to be 5. Am I right, Lina?
It is the whatever the deductible amount. Some top up have 3 lakhs, some have 5 lakhs, some have 10 lakhs, but deductible bill has to cross each time in top up.
Yeah. So, yes, Nidisha, what's the next question?
Yes, ma'am. Next question is from Amit. Which policy is best for health insurance?
See, most of the time, whenever I ask somebody health insurance, we give a 4 or 5 quotations. I always say you look at some things which is good for you. So let me see if I have my Excel ready or not. Otherwise, I'll send it across. We have a 17 different parameters when we look at across. I'll give you a simple example, like how much is
per day ICU is allowed. Okay, what is an ambulance? What is a pre-accident? There is a how many days you can claim pre and post surgery?
Pre-hospitalization.
Pre-hospitalization. Then it is talking about most of the time, very few only have started that Ayurvedic. Okay. People almost all doesn't have the Ayurvedic hospitals allowed, because nowadays, last 3 years, I have been seeing a lot of people are asking me that, Rashna, I want an Ayurvedic based. In Bangalore, there are 2 Ayurvedic hospitals are allowed in a few of them. So those are allowed or not. 99% dentals are not allowed, only one have a dental. Then it is talking about what is the things if they have a copay or not a copay. Somebody started asking me, which is there nowadays, if you have a transplant allowed or not. It was not there before. Okay, if it is a lung transplant or allowed, or what is the percentage? So there are so many 17 parameters we send. So we try to see 2 things, which is a normal comes at how much is ICU, how much is a per bed, or which room you are able to take. It's like a 5K joint room, single room, luxury room, or whatever they have, an amount is linked to that. And what is a maximum with the premium? These are the 4 things people looks at, because when we see that just a lot of people just go and see the premium and take it, but they have not seen the underlying things. Okay. So I'll give you a simple example. My own family member has admitted in a Apollo, and she was not anybody. My mom itself has there in 11 years in ICU, 11 days in ICU. And the bill came so high and we were not able to claim, because all the PP kit and all those things doesn't come under the claim section, because they have written those things. So sometimes it's easier when we are taking what is not included. Sometimes we should read it out. But mostly 4 things, please read it very clearly. Per day room, what is allowed? Per day ICU, what is allowed? Okay. These 2 are very, very important. And what is the maximum sum assured you have? And what is the premium? So those 4 things, when you are, anybody is giving you the, I can say, comparison, you can look at the comparison and take care of those. Yeah, next question, Nidisha.
Yes, ma'am. I have 50 lakhs term cover and want to increase to 1 crore. Should I go with existing insurance company or another company of 50 lakhs policy?
You're talking about term or health?
Term cover.
See, term cover, this question came very recently to me, and I was telling, don't confuse the insurance, because sometimes we really don't know if we have to claim, and if the claim doesn't come, there's no point in. So somebody says, because below 50 lakhs, there is no medical, okay? And above 50 lakhs was the medical. So that person came and asked me, Rashna, I'll take 2 medical, 250 lakhs from 2 different companies, so I don't have to go for a medical. Then I said, actually, it is not true, because when you are writing a application form, you are supposed to write if you have any other insurance, okay? Because they are also will able to check it across. They are also have an insurer or anybody to know that how much insurance you have. So this is another thing. Last 3 months, we have seen a person. I got a claim only now after 6 months, I'm telling you, because claim was not coming under a call a normal claim. Then I asked, what is the reason that person died with the COVID and you have a death certificate with the COVID? Why you are not giving a claim? So they told me, Rachna, whenever there is an early claim, and this is the new learning for me. What do you mean by early claim is, if you have taken a term cover and within 3 years, the claim comes, it comes under early claims. So they will do, underwriter do a much, much more detailed part. So whatever they have declared, is it right or not? Medicals was, because we always say no, no, no. And that guy has written no drinking. And the medical, whatever the bills, what you call the report says that he was an occasional drinker. And the claim didn't come. It came very less after going to the next level. I'm saying that because it was a COVID case. I'm just trying to say, whenever you're taking a term cover, there's nothing wrong. You can take a 2 different companies. There's nothing wrong. But make sure
please declare everything. Why we are taking an insurance? Because in case of a claim, you should be able to get a claim. So please don't try to confuse people just for a medical sake that you wanted to have the two different companies. I'm assuming it may not be medical case. If it is some other things, please go ahead and have a medical.
Yes, ma'am. The next question, if I have an individual policy for four members, can I take one floater super top for all four policies?
You have one policy and you take four super top.
Yes. Can I take one floater super top for all four policies?
I'm not sure of this.
Lina,
can you answer?
You can, because he has a four different policies for four members, that is the family members. And he is asking for floater super top of policy. It is like, no, he can have.
I'm not sure. Thank you, Lina. Yes, Vidisha. Is it any more questions are there?
Yeah, there are three questions, which is quite long. Maybe we will answer them via mail. And one more question. How much should be a term insurance and health insurance amount be?
As I told you, a health insurance is good to have at least 10 to 15 lakhs. I personally feel, of course, I have taken personally 50 lakhs, which is a beyond because my customers said and I felt it was quite reasonable. But now I have noticed actually the premiums has really gone very, very high. So if it is not, so minimum you should take it 15. If you have an employer health cover, you can do 15 minus employer and the rest you can take it across. Okay. Term cover, there is a lot of thing I can say you, I can thumb rule. Everybody have a different thumb rules for a term cover. Somebody says as per the salary, as per age, as per anything, but we normally take as per the goals. So you should take as on today, what is your all the goals present value minus all your sum assured and minus all your debt. That total we normally take for the term cover.
Yes, ma'am. The next question, can you please explain about Section 45 of Insurance Act?
I am not sure. I will get back to you. Please write. If Lina, if you are aware, can you tell me 45?
Section 45 is, it is like, no, you see, when you take an insurance, it is like that you cannot induce a person to take the insurance. Of course, insurance is always bought. It is solicited because you approach the, it is not like it is sold, it is bought. Yeah. Now there is a unethical practice in the system, in the society, that it is like, no, I'll give you a little payback, I'll give you little premium, you induce the in fact, it is like, no, so sometimes customers also demand that you give me certain percentage back, certain premium you pay. So that is called inducement, which is not allowed as per Section 45. Because in case if it is comes into the notice of the IRDA, the agent's license also can be cancelled. So that is it.
So just benefit for all, Lina is a very good friend of mine and she's been doing amazing work in insurance. Thank you, Lena. Any other questions?
Oh, ma'am, I'll read the last question. This is from Venkatesh. For working people, employer provides the health insurance till the time we are employed with the organization. Should we look at buying personal individual health insurance? Assuming I have planned to work for another 10 years till 53 years, will it be a good decision to take a personal health insurance after or before deciding to leave the job?
Yes, I was telling the same question in between my presentation, and please do take care of health insurance parallel to the corporate, because I just told you in February and March, one of our customers, he left and joined again. Three reasons for that. One is when you are leaving the company at 50, 55, you may develop some small, I can say, health issues because of aging. So sometimes you are not able to get a good health cover. Second thing is, whenever, in case if we are quitting and joining later, in between we don't have a cover at all. Third thing is, easier way is parallel, you take it a smaller cover, maybe 5 lakhs on or 3 lakhs, which is a parallel. And because when you are taking that continuingly, so you don't have to go for a medical test and anything when you are quitting. But yes, please ask this question, which I asked before also. I know at least Wipro and Infi have that question, things. When the employee quit, you can convert that same into individual health cover. Only premium goes high because you're converting a group health cover into the individual, but they are able to do it. So then it is not an issue because that 15 lakhs policy will continue, only you have to pay higher premium. So with this, I just wind up. Thanks a lot. Have a wonderful weekend and have stay safe and spread happiness. And thank you for joining always our session. Right Horizons is 18 years old wealth management firm. We'll be happy in case if you want to take any help from either health side or something. Thank you, Lina. Thanks, everybody.